Alright, everybody, we should be live again. Let me know if there are any issues as far as frame rate, or you can't hear me, you can't see the video, you know, the normal stuff. I hope we don't have any issues this week. I know I had some internet issues last week, but so far so good with internet issues. So we should be good on that. I'm going to tab out a game for just a second, guys. I just had to, I'm going to open up the qualifying tab or the qualifying page for this week. And I'm going to go over the very, very exciting 450 championship points. So last week we did run, what race was that? We ran Washougal, sorry. Obviously it was supposed to be an off week. We had some issues with the servers and everything. So we had to go back to back off, or yeah, back to back off weeks. We ran motos, and we got Washougal in the books. Millville has, yet to be posted on Race Factory, so I'm not 100% sure what's going on with that, but I believe we will be running that at the end of the year. So keeping all that in mind, Jesse Mullins is leading the championship. He's got a total of 322 points to his name. Now, Hunter Root, he is sitting in second. Hello, hello.
You good?
Yes. We should be all good. Let me just... Actually, I'm not going to tab out a game or anything like that. But I believe we are good. So you can go off and do your own thing if you want.
Sweet. See you later, Jeff.
Yep, have fun tonight, Kellen.
Thanks, mate. User left your channel.
All right, so are we not getting a... No, we are not getting a Conti race for the 450, so I have to hurry up what I'm talking about. So Hunter Root, he's sitting in second in the points. He's got 313 points to his name. So he's down by 9 points with four races to go, excuse me. We've got two motos here at Unadilla. We've got two motos at Bud's Creek next week, and then... two motos at Indiana the following week after that. And then, like I said, I'm assuming that the 450 Millville motos are going to be at the end of the year. So we've got 8 motos to go yet in the 450 class. It's going to be close. I mean, 9 points, that's not a whole lot. And Hunter's been killing it as of late. And speaking of him killing it, he was our top qualifier here at Unadilla. He ran a 202.6. The next quickest is his championship rival, Jesse Mullins, with a 204.7. So Hunter was about 2 seconds quicker than Jesse Mullins. So Root, obviously on rails here at Unadilla. He's always been a fan of Unadilla. So, I mean, it's going to be tough for Mullins. Like, there's no easy way to say it. It's going to be tough for Mullins. I know Mullins is really good at getting through the pack and everything like that, but Hunter's got the raw speed, and I think the raw speed on this track is going to help him, especially seeing the qualifying times. But then we have Tyson Fresquez sitting third in qualifying with a 205.9. And then Jack Haley sitting in fourth with a 207.3. And then to round out the top five, you have the Colonel, August Sanders, UID number 2, with a 208.2. So these top times are very, very spread out. From first to fifth, it goes from a 202.6 all the way back 6 seconds to a 208.2. So... it's going to be interesting. Now, the surprise qualifier in the 450 class for me, Kevin Furzaka. He started out on the 250s this year. opted to bump himself up to the 450 class, and he qualified eighth place with a 209.2. So he's got the speed to run up front. Let's see how well he can do in chat there. Candy Cane Wang wanted to see him mix it out. Now Hunter Root is on the way outside, so I'm not gonna go with him. Let's go with the Colonel, August Sanders. And he actually just waits on the start as well. I'm not sure if this is... Oh, Alex Heckman rips the hole shot. Is this a restart? It is not a restart, so this is legit. Heckman just railed that start. He's going for it. And then he got Tyson Fresquez. Some would call him the GOAT of MX Simulator, sitting in second. Andre Santos, he's been having very, very good results lately, sitting in third early on. Robert Wilson, Brady Stanley, Justin Harper, Kevin Terzaka, surprise qualifier, starts up front. And then you got Jesse Mullins. Where is Hunter? There he is. He's crossing the finish line now. So he's tucked back a little ways. I mean, these guys are going to be pretty stacked up for the first few laps of the race. So we will see how this pans out. Meanwhile, up front, Heckman and Fresquez going at it. Fresquez trying to look for a way around him. Heckman keeping Fresquez honest. Heckman's progressively gotten better at MX Simulator just throughout Nationals with me streaming the 450 class. Oh, and as I'm talking about him, he has a little bit of a hiccup there. Oh, and then he goes over the berm. He shouldn't lose any more spots, though. He should get up. Tyson Fresquez, he's going to have some nice, sick style. He's just going to flick at a wrist right there. And you got Heckman. Let's see how dirty he can throw it. All right, he's going to get a little sideways. Armstrong, terrible. Stanley, he's always throwing it. Santos, Wilson. Oh, and now all the dualies are coming. Oh, man, Trilies right there. Shredo throwing it with Devin Davis and Reed Young. All these guys. Kellen Brower on the two-stroke throws it. Oh, that is so sick to see. I'm actually going to get out of... there we go. And, nope, that's not going to work, so let me just... Redab. We're going to go back up front. Tyson is absolutely gone. Ooh, Hackman's having more issues. Stanley now sits in second with Santos, Armstrong, and Mullins. All right there. Robert Wilson, Jack Roberts. Ferzaka goes down, jumping back up to the start straight, and there's Hunter Root. I was going to go back to see where he was. He's not too far out from these guys, and he's got to get past Jesse as soon as he can. Jesse is very, very strong late in the motos. Not as of late, but he normally is very strong late in the motos, so Hunter's got to get around him as quickly as possible. Jesse's right here going over this little single. He's going to jump back down into Gravity Cavity. And you got Robert Wilson and then Hunter Root. So one rider separates the two championship contenders. Root with a little bit of a mistake. Root's got to get around Wilson as quickly as he can right here. Oh, Wilson with a little bit of a mistake. What line is Root going to take? He's going to go to the inside. Double. All right, he's going to be side by side with Wilson. He's got the run. Nope, he's going to... around the outside. There it is. There's the pass. So Root's making as many passes as he possibly can early on in this moto. Next rider up is going to be the red plate holder and defending champion Jesse Mullins, and these guys are going over the sky shot right now. I'm just going to keep it here. Those guys throwing some pretty sick style. There's Hunter.
Oh, Stanley went down
after the lead, or after the sky shot.
Yes. All and right. Mullins was going on the outside to set up for the double, so was not affected. Stanley stayed on the bike, though, so he's still in front of Hunter Root. Hello, everyone. It's Checker speaking, by the way.
Hello, hello. I'm just staying on the leap here, waiting for everybody to... Oh, we got quadsies right there. No, that was fived.
I wish Colin was broadcasting. He'd be hammed right now.
Right. Unfortunately, I don't have anything to drink, so I'm over here sipping on Powerade. Anyways, Tyson Fresquez.
Oh, Stanley's down now, so Root goes around him as well.
All right, we've got three of the big hitters. Oh.
Oh, Root.
Is that Magic Surfer?
Manny. I don't think so, because I switched to Mullins right away, and it
yeah.
was not like
okay.
it. At the same point, hopefully they're not targeting racers at this point.
That would be very, very unfortunate.
That'd be really unfortunate for the person doing it.
Correct. But for the time being, we've got three of the biggest hitters in the class. 1, 2, 3. Tyson Fresquez is checked out already. Then you got Jesse Mullins.
Second. And 2/10 faster for Mullins. But not much faster. He's going to need a little bit more help than that to really gap him. But we'll see as he settles in now where the pace goes. Mullins, obviously, no one to be able to throw down some hot laps. But Tyson's no slouch himself.
Absolutely.
Fresquez going to get nasty here? Not really. He's going long.
All right. I'm going to stick on Jesse Mullins here. And then I will watch everybody over the leap.
Interesting, Mullins after the sky shot is using the outside line and doing this double up the hill.
That's interesting.
I saw Fresquez going inside. Oh, Mullins was unable to jump it that time, so I'm sure he lost a little bit of time going out there.
Stanley throws it dirty over the leap. Wilson not throwing any style over the leap, which is very, very disappointing.
Holy crap, Peter Likes up in 7th right now.
St. Laurent, Devin Davis, Jack Roberts.
I was listening to the broadcast while I was loading in, and you said Strelo and Davis did dualies on the first lap. They're actually sitting in the team speak together, so that might have been a little bit planned of dualies.
Probably. I just saw Kellen Brower hit the lead on that two-stroke.
He's up to 13th.
Luke Heberlein's way back. Who's that? Jack Haley, Roy Mitchell. The entire depth team, basically. Justin Harper on that two-stroke.
All right, lap times are in. 209.1 for Fresquez, 207.3 for Jesse Mullins. So Mullins cutting into that lead a little bit. Hunter Root was at 208.8. So both second and third went faster than your leader that last lap around. Mullins' lead's down to 11 seconds right now. It's early on here. We're not even a third of the way through this thing. So Fresquez is going to have to definitely pick up the pace unless the guys behind him make mistakes or he will get caught. But, of course, catching him and passing him are two different things. Tyson thrives on the battle.
All right, I'm going to stop on the leap one more time just to give you guys an idea of how big Tyson's lead is right now. So there he is. And we're going to wait for Jesse. There's Jesse. And there's Hunter. So, top three are pretty spread out right now.
Hunter Root is also using the outside and doubling up the hill as they come up the hill right before they drop into the wall. Or, as it used to be known as Screw You before this world got too politically correct for that name.
Dualies from Wilson and Armstrong. So the first time Wilson throws it, it's a dually. But I do have to say, as of right now, Brady Stanley is winning style check. And I take that back because Peter's been throwing it dirty as well. So they're tied right now. Kevin Furzaka? Yeah. Kellen throws it fucking dirty. Wow.
Another lap in the books. This time Mullins drops to a 206.5. Fresquez at another 209. So another 3 seconds gone from that lead, and that big lead is shrinking very quickly.
Absolutely.
And what Hunter Root came across with a 207 flat. We're looking, this thing's shaping up to be a race, that's for sure. The gap is about 8 seconds between first and second, and eight more back to second and third. So Hunter Root definitely not out of this thing. Now where is Jesse Mullins running in the two spot. Fresca's leading the way.
Now they can see each other going back as Tyson was going back towards the middle part of the track. For that
and lappers
second.
Are starting, and Fresca is launching
jumps
over
one
the
of
top.
Them. Yeah.
I got the heart rate going a little bit, at least for most normal people. For Fresca's, it's probably just another day at the office.
Yeah, Tyson's a robot, so.
Sneaking around another one there.
All right, so let's see what Tyson does. Okay, he's going to go to the inside.
Using that consistent line. Now, Mullins has been trying this outside, as has Root. Gonna jump in, the rider down. He actually elects to go back to the inside this time.
Oh, and Tyson actually goes. Root. Oh, Root.
Root was tangled
Excuse
with
me.
Michael Wheeler on the sky shot. Lands it somehow. Literally landed on
yeah.
it. Started flipping.
I,
did
I
not
caught
fall
the,
off the bike.
I caught the.
Oh,
the tail
we have
end
a new
of
leader too.
Oh, absolutely. So mistakes from Fresca's allows Jesse Mullins to jump into the lead here.
Fresca's needs to lay some heat down now because Mullins' lap times are showing that he's faster. Tyson usually does get stronger at the end of the races, though. Holding out hope here that's not going to be a sleeper.
Fresca's and Mullins switching up lines in that corner as well. Mullins went to the inside. Tyson elected to go to the outside. So these guys'
They're
lines
into
are
lappers early. Fresca is launching right to the back wheel of a lapper.
These guys' lines are pretty different. These guys are gonna split these two down lappers right here. Oh, and Tyson with a mistake. Back end slid out from under him as he's about to enter that middle rut in the corner. So Jesse's starting to get away now. And Root's not too far off of Fresca's.
The thing is now, too, is Fresca's can't even see the line choices. I was wondering if he saw that Mullins was running faster laps, if
I,
he'd be
I
able
think
to pick
he
up
had,
on some of the
yeah,
lines.
I
but
think
now
he had to have known that.
But I would think that at this point of the week that they know where other guys are running, and Fresca's likes the lines he's in.
Jesse's not overdoing it on the sky shot. He's just kind of doing, you know, a little flick, and that's that. And then he, ooh, cases the double back up the hill. Tyson still going to that inside.
Hunter doubles up. We're definitely to the point of the series. I mean, every point always matters, but when things are this close, you can really sense that in the urgency from these riders. And Fresca's being between these guys is definitely helping out Jesse Mullins.
Absolutely. Last week it was the other way around. Hunter was in first and Jesse was in third. So
lap times that time around 208.2 for Mullins, 212 for Fresca's, and at 208.5 for Root. So the gap seems to be staying pretty close between first and third. Tyson falling closer to third than first at the moment. And these guys are a whopping 33 seconds in front of your fourth place rider, Brady Stanley, who has James Armstrong giving chase to him. Robert Wilson runs in the sixth spot. The locomotive, Peter Leich, checking in at the number 7 spot, riding for Prime Design Graphics. Devin Davis with a solid top 10 run going here in the number 8 spot. Wearing some sick bright orange boots. I like those. Jack Haley is up in the number 9 spot. Kevin from Zucca rounds out your top 10 on his Tagger Designs machine. So he's knocking on the door for that number 9 spot, about to drop into the gravity cavity and over the finish line. Good early run going right now for Kevin for Zucca, as we're about to the halfway point. We're about 15 minutes into this bad boy. A lot of racing left to go.
Kellen Brower still scoring points, sitting in 14th.
I was just going to say, update on Kellen Brower. He's up in 14th, but he's the second two-stroke in the field. Reed Young right now. Well, not anymore. Kellen
not anymore.
We'll have to check lap times this time around, but Fresquez has actually cut back into that lead just a little bit by a couple tenths on Mullins, and Root's got the gap down to 6.4 seconds between him and Fresquez. Jesse Mullins coming around, putting another lap in the books. The halfway flags are out for him. A 207.3, so definitely still a fast lap for Mullins. See if Fresquez can drop in his fastest lap of the race. He cannot. A 209.1. He lost a little bit of time actually at the end of that lap. Root logs in a 208.1, so Mullins actually stretched it out on both second and third. Lots of lappers. Seems like they're catching lappers faster than normal.
I'm surprised Root hasn't really gained a whole lot of time on Tyson. At least it seems like it.
Guys are pretty evenly matched, it appears, and unfortunately there's about 8 seconds between them, each of them. Keep them, otherwise it'd be an intense battle if they were all together on the track right now running these lap times.
Oh, Tyson with a little bit of a mistake, not going to fall off the bike.
Mullins just absolutely shredding the outside before the sky shot. He's coming into that thing fast. Wow. Oh, a little bit of head shake, but just so stable, like right away. His setup just stabilized itself. It's almost like you hit a hack button, a switch arcade mode on real quick or something. Oh, here go the conspiracy theorists right now.
Right.
Hashtag hacks.
Hashtag arcade mode.
And his gap just went to 11 seconds. So that means there must have been a mistake from Hunter Root. Or not Root, but Tyson Fresquez. And that put Root within 3.5 seconds of him now. Root just sending it over, jumping that table. Carrying so much speed. We're about to have a second place battle.
Yes, we are.
What's up, y'all? Checking in here. Hunter Root running in the number 3 spot. Hunter Root cares about this outdoor title so much he skipped the swimming at the Olympics to be here.
Oh, man.
All right, lap times. My favorite part of watching it when these guys are not super close to each other. 208.6 for your leader, Mullins. 211.6 for Fresquez. So he dropped 3 seconds in a 208.3. Hunter Root was the fastest rider by 0.3 out of this lead group that last lap around. Ooh, a little mistake from Root, though. It cost him a few tenths there on this lap for sure. So much of it's going to come around down to getting around all these lappers clean, as the lapper is actually getting back going right in the right side of the racetrack as Mullins comes up on him. Going to be in the preferred outside line for Mullins. Mullins luckily jumped to the inside of him, avoided that fall off crash that would have been right in front of him into the sky. So you're going to do some dualies with Wheeler. Negative. Riders getting going again in front of Mullins. Threading the needle. 921 machine doing a great job there getting out of the way. Awesome job, bro. Way to be a good lapper.
I'm pretty sure Hunter just hit that double from the second line.
Hunter is into the number two spot, by the way. I don't know if we, I don't think we called that out on the stream. You might have been watching it, but. Refresca is not able to match the top two guys thus far in Moto number one, even with a big lead and a big head start. The powers that be, Jesse Mullins and Hunter Root, have moved their way around and are putting them in their dust a little bit. Look at the 291 off the track letting Fresquez go by. That away, boy. I'm going to go find him and give him some love.
That is Chris
Clearly
Watts.
I got his, okay, I was going to say I got his number wrong, but I guess he had missed where he was at in the field. So let's watch this lead gap. It's at 10.7 seconds right now as Mullins made a small mistake. Root's now into second. Can he cut into this thing? We're 20 minutes in. 10 minutes, two laps until this thing's over.
And Hunter needs to push the issue as well. With the championship coming to an end here.
And Fresquez is down and off the bike. So he's out of this thing pretty much at this point with the speed the top guys are running.
He's pretty much locked into third, though, because he's got such a big lead on fourth.
Yeah, I mean, it's 47 seconds between third and fourth now. From Brady Stanley, they're putting in a great ride running in fourth. The mere mortals, he is winning that battle. The human class, I should say. He's winning that battle.
James Armstrong is putting in a very, very good ride as well, sitting fifth.
Jack Haley was in ninth when we did that top 10 rundown. He's up to sixth. I haven't seen a ton of him this outdoor season, but he's definitely gelling with this track. Boner down for Team Adept as they come across the finish line.
Devin Davis sitting 7th, Robert Wilson 8th. Callum Brower inside the top 10 with this 2-stroke, sitting in 9th. And then Peter Like on the ground in 10th.
Pretty sure the locomotive just derailed around that corner.
So Callum putting pretty much no time into the track this week. Says he's just going to mess around in 30th place on a 2-stroke, and he's sitting in the top 10. So, good on you, bud. Good on you.
Man, we're about to see a battle, though, for the top 10 spot. The locomotive about to get run over by a monster truck. As is a grave digger.
Who's going to win? Who's going to win this one, the grave digger or the locomotive?
Sorry, Peter, but I'm going to have to go with the grave digger on this one. Not even a ton of steel can stop the gravedigger. Don't stand on the tracks when the train's coming through. Don't be in the same county when the gravedigger's coming through.
Oh, and Peter Like just went all sorts of derp.
I think he just let him go. Would you be scared if a monster truck was coming to run you over?
Not if I was a locomotive.
Out of town too.
Not if I was a locomotive.
Peter's like, peace out. I am out of Dodge. I'll let that monster truck go smash someone else, and I'll pick up the pieces with the front of my locomotive.
Wanting nothing to do with the gravedigger, Peter Like is just like, nope. His locomotive started going to Noteville on that one.
Oh, man. Look back at the front.
Yeah.
Mullins has four riders in front of him right now. All in the same turn. This is
going
to get sketchy.
They are battling for a top 10 spots, basically. So we got five people in the air, six people in the air on the sky shot.
They're dicing hard for spots that are pretty far up the ranks. Mullins probably just trying to get the hell away from Kellen because all you can hear is the 2-stroke when you're on the track. Goes around, Strelo lets him go. Now Root's going to have to deal with that same group, though. Granted, half of them I think have crashed by now. Maybe not. Yeah, Tyson's completely lost this group. He ran a 2:24 last time around. He's 27 seconds back, but he's still got 35 on Stanley. So, but the lead gap's only 5 seconds now.
Yeah, I think those lappers kind of were in favor of Hunter Root. I mean, they're dicing for.
Fans.
they're dicing for quite a few points, so can't really fault them a whole lot, but...
This just in. Hunter Root is playing poolside from the Olympics. That's why everyone's getting out of his way. They want him to finish so that he can go win an Olympic gold medal. Get you some for the number 5 of Hunter Root. Yops, under 5 seconds now. 209.1 last time for Mullins. 207.4 even going through those lappers for Hunter Root. So those lappers didn't really check Root up much at all. Speaking of freaking freight trains, Hunter Root's been on one since the couple rounds into this championship, trying to freight train his way back to the front of the field, of the championship, I should say.
He is getting really close to Mullins.
Down to 3.5 in this race, only 9 points in the championship. He is busting that double out of the middle, or the second run out. That's incredible. I don't know if I can jump it from the outside.
Yeah, it's
Hunter Root, definitely. Insane. Speaking of hacks, he flipped on beast mode for this moto. Down to 2.8. Going around Peter Like.
He almost landed
all the way to the side of the track. Hunter Root not checking up for anybody right now.
Hunter can see Jesse. Let's go into a Hunter Root view, seeing as he plays first person.
Yeah, I'm guessing it's about 4 laps to go at this point, too. So we're 26 and a half minutes into the moto.
I believe you are right.
We will see if my math is correct that I just did on the fly. A 210 that time for Mullins. So Mullins not laying his hot laps down. Another 207.4 for Hunter Root. So Root just locking the 207s in all day, every day.
I would like to see him throw down like a 204 or something like that.
Mullins, another mistake that's going to close it up even more.
Another 3/10 just like that. Actually, 6/10, almost half a second.
And more lappers. Mullins had to get out of his main line.
Now Root is running this inside, and he's double, 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 single.
Remember, he's also doubling after the sky shot out of that inside.
Yeah.
But you have to cross jump to the outside line to do that. He's close enough now. He's under a second, half a second, up the step up. Does he strike there? Is that his place?
I don't think so.
He just made a little mistake on entry of that corner. Mullins has this corner buttered before the sky shot. So he's not gonna be close enough. But it could be a drag race up the hill by the time we get there. In about one corner, we'll find out. Mullins going to protect the inside. Makes a mistake. Root
and
still goes for the double.
Just like that. A second. Just like that. Oh, a little mistake from Root. Not going to cost him too much, though.
Root!
Almost
lands on him. I don't think Jesse's probably going to be very happy about that. Not just losing the lead, but the way that he went about it. I was waiting for Root to bust that out the way he'd been OJ in that. Every lap, I was wondering if it was possible. Is it possible on the old Unadilla? And Root just goes huge. Somehow doesn't take out Mullins. Mullins, though, I think, is fired up about the fact that he could have gotten taken out.
Actually, I'm going to stay in first person with Root until this lap is over. This is going to be a very good lap for him. A 206.0 to a 209.1 from Mullins. Actually, we're going to stay in first person with Mullins, being that
Mullins
this battle is just so close. He's
going
to jump way off to the right side of the track.
We're 29.
And Mullins goes down.
With the slide out. I was just going to say we're 29 minutes in, so there is 3 laps to go in this race. There'll be 2 lap card next time around. Now Root turned on God mode though. Can he keep it up at this pace without falling down? Or does he now turn it down a little bit and then make mistakes? Who knows?
I think that's since only... he's so hot, he's just going to keep... He's got to keep going the way he's going. I think that's the best way to prevent any mistakes from happening.
And as great as Hunter rode, especially that last lap, was insane.
Right.
Mullins was running those laps early in the race.
Like,
not the 206, but the 207s he was running, and 208s he was running early in the race. And if he kept running those, he would have been fine. But he dropped into the 210 range, 209s, and that allowed Root to close that gap really quickly.
Now, Hunter's last lap there looked very, very good. And it was only a 206. His best qualifying lap was a 202.6. So...
Well, I mean, he was clearly cutting the track, right?
Obviously.
He's got a couple lappers in front of him. Wheeler almost cuts right into him. Coming up on Davis right now. Oh, and I saw Mullins is on the ground.
Yep, he's just getting going again.
Wow, we've had some shakeups in the top 10, so let's take a quick top 10 rundown as the two-lap card's about to come out. Brought to you by versus-pc.com. Log on and buy some badass stuff. Hunter Root leads the way. Two-lap card is out for Mr. Root. Second place, Prime Design Graphics. Number one, Jesse Mullins, your defending champion and points leader. Jason Fresquez is a whopping 65 seconds behind second place right now.
That is insane.
James Armstrong has moved up into the number four spot. He's got a wild Brady Stanley trying to put the move on him.
And
with
Jack
the
Haley,
Max
this
race
is a three-way battle.
Just a second ago, Stanley was all the way back to sixth. He's clawed his way back to fifth, and now he's going for the number four spot.
If I don't see Trileys right here, I will be upset.
Well, we know Stanley will throw it. His buddy Jack Haley is going around the inside of him, though. He's going to make it two for one.
Oh, yeah! Actually, Stanley...
Falls off.
Stanley was the one that who... threw it the least. I was expecting him to just go for it.
First, I think he was leaning when he landed because he was trying to miss Haley. But I'm going to stay with this battle right
now.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Action for sure. Screw the top 10 run now. We can get back to that. Haley trying to get right back to that back wheel. They have a couple lappers in front of him. I was looking, actually, started the top 10 rundown, looking for Devin Davis because he did get lapped. He's in ninth place, so these guys have lapped inside that top 10.
Oh, lapper
oh,
getting
riders
back
everywhere.
Onto the track.
Oh, Haley's
these guys
needle.
Splitting everybody.
Haley's got a run, a nice scrub, and a rider down. He misses him. He's got
that was
a run
Heckman.
On
him. No, Armstrong closes the door.
And that scrub that Haley threw was insane.
Yeah, it was pretty nice. It was pretty nice.
You know, it's not nice. Haley's not going to be nice here in about 2 seconds because he's pushing it up the inside, trying to find a way around. He wants that number four spot. Armstrong holding tough, though. There was a little mistake from Armstrong. It's going to allow Haley to close right back up again.
Armstrong goes way outside. Haley elects to keep it in the middle of the track right
now,
there.
Haley about made a two for one on the inside here last lap. Can he do it this time with just one guy in front of him? Here he goes.
Oh, he's carrying that speed. Armstrong has nothing for him either.
Perfectly executed that inside, makes the move on James Armstrong.
Armstrong did throw dirty over the sky shot, though. I will give him that.
And he goes for the double out of the middle rut
and
falls
off.
So that's going to put the end of that battle. So let's finish the top 10 run down here. Picking up with our leader, Hunter Root at the lead. Mullins still in second.
Whoa, hold on.
Third.
Sorry. Root has absolutely left Mullins. Like, there's
yeah, Mullins
nothing.
Had a fall off, remember?
Right, but like even after that, that's a pretty big lead.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, Fresca's third. Haley has now settled himself into fourth. He does fall over, but I think he's fine. Brady Stanley's back into fifth, battling with Armstrong. So, Armstrong battling again, just this time for fifth instead of fourth. And then Robert Wilson runs in the seventh spot. Devin Davis in eighth. And there's the Gravedigger running in the number nine spot. And rounding out your top 10, the locomotive, Peter Like.
Colin Brower has tanked it just a little bit, sitting in a 16th, I believe. Yep. But we are on the white flag lap, and actually Hunter's about to finish this one. So Hunter Root shortens the gap.
Terrorizes moto number one at Unadilla.
He shortens the gap on that points lead. It's now down to just 6 points.
Wow.
So, is it panic mode for Mullins, or do you think he's going to turn it around over the next couple weeks? I mean, we've got moto yet today, or tonight.
I would uncover that panic button if he does not get some of those points back on Hunter Root and moto number two.
Yeah, Hunter's been on a roll as of late, as Jesse Mullins crosses the finish line in second. And then we've got a long ways to go until Tyson Fresquez finishes. He just jumped the sky shot. Coming back up the hill now. He actually doubled from the
middle. We have a last lap battle to watch, though, for fourth, fifth, and sixth. I mean, Stanley and Armstrong going at it. Armstrong just made a mistake with a slide off. But didn't fall off the bike. Gave the spot to Stanley, but they're still pretty close. These are the last two riders on the lead lap, fifth and sixth. Seventh on back, y'all are a lap down, y'all need to pick up the pace.
Oh, Haley's having some issues. Meanwhile,
Stanley slides out. Armstrong bumps into him.
All right, Tyson Fresquez finishes in third. It looks like Haley should be safe to finish in fourth, barring any fall-offs, I should say.
Yeah, it's all down to this fifth-place position right now.
Stanley
absolutely
ripped
that
right outside.
You can keep her on two, and then it'll come down to cuts, of course.
All right, so unofficially, the top five is going to be Hunter Root, Jesse Mullins, Tyson Fresquez, Jack Haley, and Brady Stanley. Armstrong with a sixth, Robert Wilson seventh, Devin Davis eighth, Luke Heberlein ninth, and Peter Like to round out the top ten. Now, there are a few spots in the top ten that could be affected by cuts, so we will keep an eye on those. Cuts are in, and Armstrong gets fifth, and that's the only one in the top 10 that's going to change. So Reed Young 11th, Kevin Furzaka 12th, Jack Roberts 13th, Kellen Brower 14th, August Sanders actually gets 15th from teammate Roy Mitchell, who finishes 16th due to cuts, Mike Strelo, and then William St. Laurent gets 18th from Tyler Crane, who finishes 19th, and then Ethan Parks to round out the top 20. Alex Heckman, he got the hole shot. He absolutely ripped the hole shot. Finishes 23rd. So, with a 1450 moto at Unadilla in the books, Hunter Root now behind by just 6 points. That's two moto wins. Two more moto wins. And we've got five motos plus Millville. I'm not too sure what's going on with Millville.
Wow. What's this Millville that you speak of? I know nothing about it.
Well, the results aren't posted yet, so I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, I actually have no idea either. I have no clue. I was just disconnected from the internet for what seemed like a month when I was at Loretta's, so.
Yeah, right, there's not a whole lot going on. I'm just kind of waiting for...
I hate to break it to you, but
number two.
I know what's going on, and that is that I am going to bet. So that means you are on your own for moto number two.
That is okay. Sleep tight.
I filled it with commentary for moto number one, so that's good news, at least.
Yeah, I mean, the racing kind of made it fun, so... So that's always good, but I will not keep you any longer. Have fun tonight, Chris.
Yeah, absolutely. Best of luck to Hunter Root at the Olympics. Hopefully he can bring home a medal.
Oh, man.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
All right.
Thanks
see
for
you, Chris.
Tuning in.
User disconnected from your channel.
All right, guys, so we're just waiting, waiting on this, restart for 450 moto number two. Alright guys, so to get the chat a little bit interactive, who do you think's gonna win moto number two here at Unadilla? Please let me know. Kellen's gonna win. I mean, I'm always rooting for Kellen. Looks like we've got a lot of Kellen fans. That is definitely the wrong lineup that they posted. Alright, I believe it's been more than 5 minutes, but that is none of my business. Let's go, guys. Alright, there we go. And that is still the wrong lineup, I believe, but... okay. That is definitely not the lineup that we're supposed to have, so I'm not too sure... not too sure what's going on. These guys should get the restart here. But for the time... yep, there's the red flag call. So this race is not going to count. Man, the forums would have erupted if there was no red flag. And there we go. So now this should be the correct one. We got Harper, Dorian. Yep, this one's definitely going to be the right one. I'm going to go on board with Hunter Root, though. Just as soon as everybody loads in. Looks like we're waiting on a few more guys. Luke Heberlein, Reed Young, and I don't know who that is, but he is ready. Oh, that was Blake Ryan. Or Blake O'Brien, sorry. Now we're only waiting on the Gravedigger, Luke Heberlein. And there we go. So Hunter Root actually has the inside gate now. Very interesting. And then you see towards the way right side of my screen, Jesse Mullins and Tyson Fresquez over there. Hunter doesn't get the jump this time around, but he's going to sneak around the inside. He's got a great start. A very, very good start for Hunter Root, and that's what he needs, especially if Jesse has gone down in the first corner, which I believe he did. Didn't see him. Oh, no! And then who is it? August Sanders gets together with Hunter Root. So Hunter gets what he need, or he got what he needed, and it was all for nothing. August Sanders' line coming together with Hunter's. And that is not good. Brady Stanley now leads this thing with Devin Davis second, Trevor Dorian third, Jack Haley fourth, Wilson fifth, Farzaka sixth, Haley seventh, and he definitely lagged out, but he should be coming back in fairly soon. And Jesse Mullins is actually sitting up front, so that is very, very, very unfortunate for Hunter Root, as you can see him back here with Nate Zaworski, and he actually gets together with Nate Zaworski and goes, Nate goes down. Tyson Prescott is down over here. Wow, there's so much stuff going on back here. So we're going to go up our back up front. So, Root had an opportunity, but kind of got the short end of the stick there, and I totally just missed everybody hit the leap on the first lap. What am I doing? Bergeron absolutely through that. If everybody's as close as these guys are next lap, I'll remember to get it. But for now, Brady Stanley leads this thing. Devin Davis sitting in a very, very solid second. I love the boots that Devin's running right now. Very, very cool. And then, oh, Kevin Furzaka is sitting in third, so awesome ride for Kevin. Reed Young, the two smoker, sitting fourth. Jack Roberts fifth, Armstrong sixth, and then we got a host of other guys. Where is Jesse Mullins? There he is. That he's going to be sitting in 11th or 12th. Yeah, he's sitting in 11th. Yep, and he just got destroyed. So Root had to check up, which was really unfortunate for Tyson because Tyson was following him. But Hunter Root got back around his championship rival right there, the red number one of Jesse Mullins. Oh, wow! Michael Wheeler just absolutely annihilated Roy Mitchell. Wow, I'm glad I got that on stream. Michael Wheeler's bike just broke, literally. Anyways. Let's catch some guys going over the sky shot. How about start it off with a... Oh, that is not what I want to be happening. Let's see if that keeps happening. Nope. There we go. We'll watch this for a little bit and then we'll get back to it. Oh, nice dualies from the KTMs. Alright. Oh, Tyson's down again. Now, Jesse Mullins, I feel like he's very, very upset. For good reason, though. But Hunter Root also has the right to be upset. Of course, Hunter had a great start. And he lucked out because Jesse was actually down in the first corner. And had some issues, to say the least. But Hunter Root is doing very, very well. And Devin Davis winning this thing right now. With all this carnage going on behind him, he's just running a very, very consistent, keeping it on two wheels type race. And that's what he's got to do. Brady Stanley, he had some issues. He's now sitting in second. Kevin Furzaka, again, he's just running this consistent race while all this carnage is going on behind him. And it's paying out for him. And as I'm saying that, he just did about four and three quarters front flips. So that's going to allow James Armstrong, Kellen Brower, Reed Young, and Hunter Root to all get around him, along with Jesse Mullins. So after all of this, Hunter and Jesse are still fairly close to each other. But Hunter Root is on rails right now. Going back up front. Want to see these guys hit the sky shot. Brady Stanley throwing it. Connection lost. Connected. All right, not too sure why I just disconnected from TeamSpeak, but all right. Ooh, James Armstrong is down. Looks like Kellen Brower and Hunter Root threw some pretty sick dualies. Root is getting it right now. Ooh. Some issues for Devin Davis as he's now sitting in second. Brady Stanley retakes the lead. Hunter Root now sits in third. Kellen Brower sits in fourth on the 250. Alex Heckman fifth. Jesse Mullins sixth. Fresquez seventh. Furzaka, oh, and a host of others. That's Reed Young. That's going to rip the outside. He's not going to get the job done on Furzaka, though. For the time being, at least. Ooh. Reed Young stayed a little bit lower on this little tabletop. Furzaka's got the inside, and he could not use the 450 power to his advantage right there. He's going to lose the spot to Reed Young. He's got a Jack Roberts all over the back of him. Luke Heberlein's up there as well. I really want to see how this battle is going to shape up. We've got Mullins in what place is he in? Fifth. Kellen in fourth and Hunter in third. Now lap times, Jesse's fastest is only a 218. Hunter's is a 210. Obviously, both of those lap times are going to drop. But how far are they going to drop and when can they start dropping them? I believe Hunter's back on pace now. He actually just passed Devin Davis, who was down on the top of that little tabletop. So Hunter now sits in second. Now remember, guys, Jesse's points lead is only at 6 points. So if Hunter can get up into the lead and Jesse's still going to be hanging around that fifth place spot. Actually, if he gets fourth or worse, Hunter will overtake the points lead. Ben Lake, your game may have lagged out a little bit. I'm pretty sure this is... Oh, wait, no, I lagged out, so that is my fault here. Let me disconnect and reconnect. I'm so sorry for that. That's why... Okay, I think my internet connection may have dropped for just a second. There we go. All right, let's go back up front then. Once again, guys, I do apologize for this. So, maybe it wasn't mine. Maybe mine was fine and I looked at the laps wrong. But Brady Stanley is still leading this thing. Hunter Roots sits in second. Kellen Brower third. Jesse Mullins is off the bike in fourth. That's going to allow Devin Davis and Alex Heckman to get around. Luke Heberlein's going to be coming up as well. Not going to be able to pass him, but he will be behind. And you guys want an onboard of Kellen? All right, let's do it. On that 252 smoke, the last race of the year for Kellen is he is not going to be around for the last two rounds. Said he just wanted to have some fun tonight, and he's having some fun and doing very, very well. So now sits in third. He's got a little ways. That's actually Nate Zaworski that he lapped. Obviously, Nate's one of our very, very good friends here at Start Your Systems. These two are planning on just both running the 252 stroke, having some fun, you know. Not really worrying about a damn thing. And here's Kellen sitting in third in the second moto here at Unadilla. So... And throws it absolutely dirty over the sky shot. Absolutely love it. Kellen is losing time on the leaders, but he's still sitting in third either way, so... Actually, Kellen's gained some time on Brady Stanley. That's actually allowed Hunter Root to regain the lead. Or actually not regain. He's actually moved up into the lead. Excuse me. So mistakes for Brady. That was an entire lap on board with Kellen Brower, just about. Jesse sitting in fourth, he's got to go. I mean, we're about 12 and a half minutes into the moto, so there's still time for him for damage control. I think Hunter is just too far already. He's about to hit the sky shot. And the way he's been racing or riding as of late has been unreal. So, I don't really know. Brady Stanley able to hit. Oh, no, he's not able to hit that. And Jesse Mullins actually is in third now. Kellen Brower with some issues before this left-handed sweeper coming up to the sky shot. We're going to watch him go over here. Nice little style there from Kellen Brower. Love it. Oh, Kellen is actually... So, hold on a second. We're going to do a top 10 rundown here. This one's going to be presented by Race Tech Suspension. Hunter Root leads this thing as he crosses the finish line. Then we got Brady Stanley sitting in second. So, two solid motos from Brady. Jesse Mullins sits in third. He needs to go, and he needs to go now. Luke Heberline sits in fourth, so... Haven't really seen Luke up front as of late, but sitting up front right now. And then you got Devin Davis sitting fifth. Kellen Brower sits in sixth now. James Armstrong seventh. Reed Young eighth. William St. Laurent ninth. And August Sanders to round out your top 10. But he is battling with Andre Santos for that last spot inside the top 10. Both of them going to the inside here. I'm going to stay on board with this battle until something happens. Although I do want to make sure I don't miss anything up at the front. Oh, and there goes August Sanders. So let's go back up front. And Brady Stanley went down. So Hunter Root sits in first and Jesse Mullins sits in second. So... And then Luke Heberline passes Brady Stanley for third. Kellen Brower has worked his way back up into fifth. Let's go first person over the sky shot. So Devin Davis is having some issues. He dropped from fifth to seventh. About halfway over with this moto. Kellen Brower is going to get pulled down the start or down this straightaway here from James Armstrong, who's on the 450. Of course, Kellen Brower on that 250. If you or if you couldn't hear, I should say. These two battling it out for the time being for P number 5. I'm just going to quickly take a peek up front. Nothing really going on. These guys are all separated. There's a little bit of a battle for third. Armstrong is starting to leave Kellen here. Oh, nice dualies from Heberlein and Stanley. And Heberlein, oh no, Jesse's actually down. Jesse's going to get passed by both of them, so he's going to fall from second to fourth. So, as it sits right now, if the moto were to end, Jesse Mullins is no longer our points leader here in the 2016 National Series. Oh, and Jesse actually got around. No, he didn't. Just, oh, wait. Yeah, what happened to Heberlein? Heberlein with some issues. So Mullins has regained the points lead. And is he going to lose him again? No, he did not fall off the bike. So Jesse Mullins is still our points leader here in the 2016 Ride365.com Nationals powered by Versus-PC.com. Course, the series coming to an end here in the next few weeks or so. We've got two more full rounds, and then we still have to figure out what's happening with the Millville motos. What are the lap differences between Root and Mullins? Well, Root has a 206.2 fastest lap, and he's 34 seconds out front. We're gonna watch him hit the leap, because why not? There you go. And Jesse Mullins has a 206.1, and he almost just killed himself. So lap times are pretty much identical, although Jesse Mullins is sitting in third, and Hunter Root is about 40 seconds out front. Jesse needs to stop it up, though, because there's a trail of guys that can get around him if he goes down. Oh, and Jesse with a mistake. He doesn't go down. Fortunate enough for him, and then more mistakes, so he is all over the place. Lapper down, that's going to force Heberlein to switch up his lines. He's going to lose a little bit of time on Jesse Mullins. Ooh, Brady Stanley with some issues, so Mullins still has a shot at second. Honestly, if he could salvage a second, I think he would be okay with that. Obviously, he's going to lose 6 points on the day doing that, but for how this second moto has gone for him, I think he'd be okay with that. Mistake again from Mullins. Let's look for a battle here. Here's a battle. We got a very large battle. St. Laurent, Santos, Mitchell, Fresquez, and Sanders all battling it out. There's a leper in there somewhere. I think he's trying to get out of the way. There he is. I don't have his skins, so. But Tyson Fresca's not having the best of motos. Trying to get around Roy Mitchell right now. Unable to do so. He had to check up a little bit in that corner. Otherwise, his front tire was going over that rut. Oh, and Santos is down. Able to jump over him are Roy Mitchell and Tyson Fresquez. Fresquez has the inside on Mitchell. He's got the spot. He's got a lapper in Michael Wheeler right in front of him. He's going to get around him as well. He's going to just flick it over the sky shot along with Roy Mitchell. Wheels landed up in the little pond. Birdie, I'm not 100% sure on release dates for all these tracks. They wanted to do about a month or so after the race date. But I'm not so certain that they've been sticking to that schedule. I mean, the tracks are going to be released regardless. It just, I'm not exactly sure when. And Tyson Fresquez with a mistake, that's going to allow Roy Mitchell to get back around him. Make sure I didn't miss anything up front, and of course I did. That's normally how it goes. So it's Hunter Root, Brady Stanley, Luke Coverline, and then Jesse Mullins. So now again, Jesse Mullins no longer the points leader if it finishes like this. Alright, let's see what Mullen or Haberline does. He's go okay, and then Mullins, he's gonna not jump it. Maybe he's fallen too much there, and he just doesn't want to risk it. Ooh, Haberline goes down, so that's gonna allow Jesse Mullins back into third. Now, as it if it were to finish right now, Mullins has the points lead. I believe it'd be by one though. Yes, it'd be by 1 point. Armstrong is now sitting in fourth, Haberline fifth, Devin Davis sixth, and Kylan Brower is seventh, Roy Mitchell eighth, Fresquez ninth, and Sanders 10th. None of those guys are jumping that double now. But we have less than 5 minutes to go. I will get an estimation on how many more laps we have when Hunter Root crosses the finish line next. I believe it's going to be 4 to go, but I'm not 100% sure on that. Brady Stanley still sits in second, so awesome ride for him. Then you got Mullins. Mullins has a little bit of a gap on Armstrong now, so that's always good for him. There you go, Mullins now jumps it. And he's actually caught up to Brady, so I don't know if Brady's just having some issues or what. I know Mullins' lap times haven't been the greatest. He still hasn't done better than that 206.1. Hunter Root hasn't done better than his 206.2, but he's 30 seconds out front, so it doesn't really matter for him. Mullins is the fastest guy out on the track, though. Always got to keep an eye on Tyson Fresquez. Oh, and Tyson goes down before the sky shot. That was kind of a weird fall off. Or not even a fall off, just a weird, like, little tip over. Let's see Bergeron. He threw it. Aww. He threw it on the like first or second lap. Yeah, so it's going to be three to go next time by. And I believe Jesse Mullins is thankful for that, as, I mean, he's got a very, very large lead on Heberline. Actually, Armstrong was in that spot earlier. So mistakes from Armstrong. And these mistakes are actually allowing Devin Davis to rip right past Armstrong for the, I believe that's fifth. Oh, Armstrong goes down. Devin almost goes with him. Heberline just sent it, too. All right, we've got three to go, guys. Three more laps to go. Root just making this track look easy. Makes it look like a stock track in a way. Root just absolutely threw it over the sky shot. Oh, here's a battle. So Jesse could even... Oh, man. He could salvage some more points here if possible. Let's go on board with him. He's got to weave his way through lappers and a leggy Australian. He gets around Brady. Oh, and Brady's with a mistake, so that basically just seals the deal for Mullins, at least for the time being. Oh, and Brady actually doesn't go down because of that lapper. Oh, and that's actually... No, that wasn't Mullins. Excuse me. I saw red and I automatically thought that it was Mullins, but it was not. So, Hunter Root. About a lap and three quarters to go here. Jesse Mullins sits in second. Brady Stanley third. Luke Heberline fourth. James Armstrong... fifth. Devin Davis sixth. I'm not sure what Nathan Zaborski was doing right there, but wow. August Sanders seventh. Tyson Prescott's eighth. Roy Mitchell ninth. And Kellen Brower to round out the top 10 here in Moto number 2 at Unadilla. For Zaka, he was up front early on. Not too sure what's happening with him. Brady down again. Man, Haberline's gonna be getting close here if Stanley keeps it up with these mistakes. There's like literally no battles going on. This Armstrong Davis battle has been going on for what seems to be ages. This one's most likely going to come down to the last lap. Actually, Armstrong is starting to pull away from Davis a little bit. Really nothing going on. Callum Brower and Nathan Zaworski has a lapper going over the sky shot. Oh, wow! Callum just threw it. We have the white flag out, by the way, as Hunter Root's coming up to the sky shot one last time. And not as much style as I thought he was going to throw, but it is what it is, I guess. Hunter Root just kind of putting around, it seems like. Hunter Root has this one in the bag, noticeably on cruise control though, because it seems as if Jesse Mullins is closing in rapidly. That's the last big jump here, and then he's just going to drop down to the gravity cavity one more time. And Hunter Root goes 1-1 on the day and a 720 to end it. So he's going to gain a total of 6 points on Jesse Mullins today. Jesse Mullins' lead in the points standings diminishing. He's got only a 3-point lead now going into Bud's Creek next week, as Jesse Mullins goes 2-2 on the day here at Unadilla. Obviously can't be too happy with that. He's probably going to rage disco right here. Not yet, at least. Luke Haberline finishes third here in the second moto. Brady Stanley, I believe he's actually going to get third overall. I think he went 4-3, so... awesome ride for Brady Stanley, rounding out the podium. And then you got Devin Davis sitting in fifth right now, so an awesome second moto for Devin. Fifth place for Devin, like, nice little bike hump. James Armstrong is going to cross the line in sixth. August Sanders is coming around. He's going to drop down into the gravity cavity. August Sanders, the Colonel, finishes 7th here in moto number 2. Oh, here's a battle. Roy Mitchell and Andre Santos. Santos is going to scrub this little step up. He's got to rail this. Not going to do so. And oh, mistake from Santos. That's going to allow Roy Mitchell to lock in that 8th place position. Andre Santos, 9th. And Kellen Brower on the 2 smoke. Nice bike comp from him. Rounds out the top 10 here, moto number 2 at Unadilla. And then you got Reed Young, Tyson Fresquez, Kevin Ferzaka, Samuel Bergeron, William St. Laurent, Ethan Parks, Josh Hamilton, Jack Roberts, Justin Harper, and Tyler Crane to round out the points. We are going to wait till cuts are in, though. Waiting out a few more guys to finish up, it seems like. Nathan Zaworski looks like he's the last guy on the track circulating. And there it is. So, are cuts going to affect anything? Nothing has been affected by cuts, so that's going to do it. Hunter Root gains 6 more points on Jesse Mullins, so Jesse's lead going into next week at Bud's Creek is only going to be 3 points. So that's going to do it here at Unadilla for racing. Now, next week, remember, I am tired. Kellen had mentioned it before he went off air. Neither Kellen or myself are going to be around next week for Bud's Creek, but we do have a fill-in streamer, so you don't have to go anywhere else. Twitch.tv/startyoursystemsTV. We've got our buddy Storkin, as some of you may know him. He's going to be filling in for the Bud's Creek stream. And then I might be back for the Indiana stream. I'm not 100% sure quite yet, but we will see. So, guys, Storkin, he will be filling in next week for us at Bud's Creek. So, Kellen's actually done racing for the year. Great way to finish it off with that top 10 in moto number 2. But, guys, next week, Bud's Creek should be an awesome race. Shouldn't miss a beat. Storkin's going to do a great job with the stream. But other than that, guys, it was awesome streaming tonight. I had a lot of fun. And I will see you guys in 2 weeks, most likely. 2 weeks. I will see you guys at Indiana. So have fun next week. And, yeah, like I said, just have some fun. And we'll see you when we see you. All right, guys.